Kevin Durant made his highly anticipated return last night after missing a month. KD scored 11 before injuring his Achilles early in the second quarter. KD leaving the arena on crutches, wearing a walking boot. Reports say he tore the Achilles. Now, the Warriors got the win, but KD was on everyone's mind after the game, including Warriors president Bob Myers. Take a listen.
He was cleared to play tonight. That was a collaborative decision. I don't believe there's anybody to blame, but I understand this world. And if you have to, you can blame me. I run our basketball operations department. And let me tell you something about Kevin Durant. Kevin Durant loves to play basketball, and the people that questioned whether he wanted to get back to this team were wrong. And I'm not here to... He's one of the most misunderstood people. He's a good teammate. He's a good person. It's not fair.
Strong words from a clearly emotional Myers. Shannon, what do you think? Is anyone to blame for KD's injury?
Hell yeah. And Bob Myers couldn't even shed real tears. I've heard of dry shampoo, but I've never heard of dry tears. He couldn't even muster a tear because it was reported, Skip, the organization felt that Kevin Durant was not as injured as he said he was, and he wasn't fighting as hard as he needed to get back on the court. It was also reported that some of his teammates felt that Kevin Durant wasn't pushing to get back on the court. Here's Bob Myers saying Kevin Durant loved to play the game of basketball. Now, I want to know who in the organization, Skip. Was it the secretaries? Was it the custodians? Or was it the people that do the meal service? I need to know the people in the organization because it said people in the organization. It said teammates of his. Question. Really? Hold on. What the hell is this? This is not a DJ Khaled or our album or a collaborative issue. This is why. Players do not trust team doctors because at the end of the day, what are they, Skip? They are team employees, and it's big on their resume because if I'm a team doctor and someone wants to bring their child, a son or daughter, if he's good enough to be the doctor for Kevin Durant, Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, well, he's damn sure good enough to be a doctor for my son or daughter. Skip, this is bull jive, and you and I, we talked about it from the very first time it happened. I say, Skip, I've never seen anybody put ice on a calf injury that low behind his heel. I say, I don't know, have any inside information, but I've seen enough Achilles tear up close and personal. The first thing the guy does is he looks back. And I remember in practice, a guy tore his Achilles. He asked me, did I kick him? Did I trip him? I'm like, nah, man, I ain't trip you. That's what Kevin Durant did, Skip. He looked back. He didn't grab his calf. He looked back because he thought P.J. Tucker kicked him or P.J. Tucker tripped him. And then for Steve Kerr to say after the game, the doctor said he couldn't hurt it any worse than it already was. Skip, if that's not malpractice, I don't know what is. Because the man had a slight tear in that Achilles. I don't care what they say. Skip, this is wrong. And they put that undue pressure on Kevin Durant to get out there. Because I know, being an ex-professional athlete, Skip, let me tell you, this is how they go about doing it. You okay? How far along are you? Because, man, we could sure use you out there. Just your presence. Man, you know how those guys rally around you, man. Man, you can bring these guys together, man. KD, boy, if we could just get you out there, we don't need you to be your normal KD self. Just your presence. And watch how the guys pick up. That's how they put that pressure on you. But this is why, again, Kawhi Leonard went outside and got independent doctors to tell him, say, nah, bruh, I don't know if Kevin Durant went and got independent evaluation, but he should have. This injury, it might have happened, Skip, say, 6 months or a year down the road. This injury should have never happened last night. Kevin Durant, I don't care what anybody says, Kevin Durant should not have played last night.
Okay, let's go back to the start. The Warriors said from the start, it's a calf strain. That was the official report. And Steve Kerr stuck by it at every press session, media session he did. It's a calf strain. Nothing about the Achilles tendon, though you and I initially thought it's got to be an Achilles injury. And every time we saw Kevin with ice bags on, they were way down low on the ankle where the Achilles attachment is.
Achilles attached to the heel, yes.
Okay, so let's take the party line. Let's just say it was a calf strain. If that's the God's truth, then what happened last night had absolutely nothing to do with the calf strain, because I know enough about Achilles and calves that one does not lead to the other. That if you have a calf strain, it does not make your Achilles more vulnerable. The only way your Achilles is vulnerable is if it is compromised in some way. If it has been frayed, or if it has what they call micro tears in it, you can see it on the MRI. You can just see the little white dots that it's got small tears in it. Maybe it had even a significant tear. I don't know. But if it was just a calf strain, it's an apple to the orange. And if they're being honest about that, then last night was just a freakish bad break, because one had nothing to do with the other. He just happened to rupture his Achilles, if in fact that's what it ends up being. We think that's, according to all the reports, it's going to be ruptured. If he ruptured it with a calf strain, then one did not lead to the other. It was just a horrible break for Kevin Durant. But if they knew, to your point, that the Achilles had any sort of even the most minor injury, it is vulnerable. And if you go back and you try to protect it or you favor it, it can go like that. It is a ticking time bomb. So to me, the shock to me of the night was that if you watch the pregame warmups, Kevin looked like he was 100% healthy in pregame. He was just doing a solo warm-up. He was moving and grooving. He was pushing off on his jump shots. He was powering to the rack and slamming it and jumping hard off that bad leg. And I was like, man, if that was just a calf strain and he looks that healthy last night, now I'm starting to wonder, why didn't you play in game four,
right?
You know?
There you go. Okay. Now you're talking, Skip. Okay. Now you're talking.
So it was shaking me up, because that's why that point spread plummeted last night, you know, by about 2 full points by game time. Well, yeah. In fact, it went more. No, it went 3.5 plus 1, because by game time, Golden State was favored by a point, and it opened at Toronto -3.5. So the betting public, correct, Vegas, they're on Kevin Durant, because they think he's completely healthy. And they were right for a little while. And again, they were right in the end, just because I guess it was a push. But the point was, no, they were, yeah, their favorite, so it was a push. So the point of this is, I don't know. Did he have some Achilles, even what you'd call a minor Achilles injury, where it was just micro tears, and he felt pressured because DeMarcus rushed back, and then Clay rushed back, and then Looney rushed back, and Iggy had rushed back, right? They had all rushed back. It's desperate straits. You're down 3-1. And he says, well, okay, my Achilles is a little compromised, but maybe I can muddle through this. Maybe it'll be okay. And by all accounts, they signed off on it. And then Shannon, he had to sign off on it in the end, right? Did he feel pressure to sign off?
Yeah. Exactly, because they kept putting that pressure on him to begin with. Skip, the one thing we know about Kevin Durant, what does he hear? Everything that's being said about him, be it social media, be it on television, be it on radio, in the newspaper, he hears everything. So if this is coming from my organization, Skip, you look at Bob Myers. Did you see a tear?
No.
Did you see any resemblance of a tear?
No, but...
If you want to blame someone, blame me, because I'm the president of basketball operation. You're also probably one of the ones... Look, when we hear things that come from the organization, it's coming from head coach, it's coming from general managers, president of basketball operations, Skip. That's who's doing the speaking. They're not going around asking no secretaries, no custodian, no meal prep what's going on. And the players, they put that pressure because you mentioned it. Clay got back out there with a hamstring. Kevon Looney got out there with torn cartilage, which I played with. Mm-hmm. Andre Iguodala. Yeah. He's
DeMarcus rushed back from a torn quad. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Now, here he is. He's trying to rush back to a piece. And, Skip, here's the thing. You know how this works. You've covered this game far too long. It get to a point where the guys actually see themselves because you spend so much time with the guy next to you. You see that guy's your brother. You see that guy's your family. And you don't want to let him down. I don't want to let Sterling Sharp down. I don't want to let Libby Sharp down. I would do anything to get back out there and to help them. Kevin Durant says, man, you know what? You're right. Let me give this thing a go. Against his better judgment. Skip, I don't know if he got a second opinion or a third opinion. But I can tell you what, when guys normally have this kind of money, this is why they go outside and get second and third opinions, because at the end of the day, that team doctor works for that team.
Mm-hmm.
And his bread is buttered by that team. He doesn't work for Kevin Durant. I need to go to someone independent that has no dog in the fight, because if I got a dog in the fight, you damn well better believe I want my dog to win.
So it was interesting last night in telling that Steve Kerr would not touch this when he addressed the media. He kept saying, I defer to Bob Myers. He'll handle all this. So Steve Kerr had no opinion on whether he should or shouldn't have played.
And Skip, hold on. Wasn't it Steve Kerr that says, you know, he's going to give it a go? He's very close. He's going to do this. He's going to do that. Now, all of a sudden, you want to turn everything over to Bob Myers.
Mm-hmm. So when Bob Myers sat up there, help me out, you know, forgive me for this. I'm being a little cold-blooded cynical. But remember, Bob Myers' job desperately hinges next year on trying to keep Kevin Durant in Golden State. So he's going to cry fake tears, maybe, exaggerated
crocodile
tears.
Fake.
Yeah, yeah. He's going to do like that. And then he's going to say, he's the most misunderstood person. Yeah, yeah, we get all that. But I don't know. I think Draymond understood him pretty well when they got into it on the bench last November in that Clippers game, right?
Well, Bob Myers has the perfect job, because he could not be an actor. Because the thing that all actors can do is cry on command. And he couldn't even get up there after having hours to muster it up. Mm-hmm. Go to the harshest thing that's ever happened in your life. Because that's what actors say they do. They go to that moment that's most painful there, and the tears just flow freely. He couldn't even get to that point, Skip.
Okay. So now to Kevin's looming free agency. Will whatever team still give him the max? Sure they will.
Hell yeah.
Will they just say, okay, we'll put him on the shelf for maybe a year. Could take a year. It took DeMarcus almost a year to get back from his, right?
Basically, he got hurt in January. He came back in January. So basically, it was a year.
Okay.
So that's what you're looking at, Kevin Durant. You're looking at Kevin Durant sometime or probably around 2020 season. Not the first part of 2020, the next part of 2020.
Okay. Yeah, would the Knicks or the Nets or the Lakers or the Clippers take a shot? Sure, they're going to take a shot and give him the max, because they'll say, we'll put him in mothballs for a year and then we'll have him for three more years after that.
Absolutely, Skip.
The Achilles surgery is so much better today. The rehab is so much smarter today that the odds on success, I would give it a 90% chance of getting back at 100%. And it didn't used to be that way. Mm-hmm. It was more of an X factor.
Right.
So will Kevin almost certainly come back full strength from this? Almost certainly he will.
You're right, Skip, but it's also one of the injuries that's most likely to get re-injured again, even before the healing process is complete. We saw what happened with John Wall. Yeah. We saw Jason Peters.
Yeah.
We've seen D'Angelo Hall.
Can happen.
Said he tore his, made a sudden movement, and boom, it went again.
No, I agree.
It's also one of the injuries
dicey.
That when you have it, you better be really, really careful.
And Shannon, KD's a big man with a lot of weight on that Achilles as well. An MRI later today should tell us more, answer some of these questions.